So Dr. Francis Press Wilson used to say that the reason why black people ask different variations of what is happening to each other, what's up, what up, what's happening, what's going on, is because subconsciously we don't know what's happening. In Newark, New Jersey, they are poisoning our brothers and sisters there. And the news is barely even talking about it. The lead levels are off the charts. And I saw articles dating as far back as 2015, 2014. That's just what I saw. So I just want you to take a look at what is happening. And right now they have a new mayor. And it's so ironic that their new mayor's name is Barack. I can't make this up.
Residents say the Barack administration has mishandled the latest crisis of filtered water showing lead levels above the EPA's action level, the result of corrosion control not up to par at the Pequannock treatment plant that serves the western half of the city.
I'm not concerned about that right now. I'm concerned about getting through this this lead issue that we have in the city. I mean, when election time come around, we'll talk about that.
Last week, a federal judge heard the city was giving water to customers of the Wanacue district that serves the eastern part of the city while fighting a lawsuit demanding the same. The judge said, I have to say that there does appear to be a haphazardness in the manner in which we are dealing with this awful situation.
That is our policy. We give them away water to folks, but we know everybody doesn't need it. And the important thing, and it's important for us to make people understand that, because everybody in the city does not have a lead service line issue.
The governor has declined to declare a state of emergency, which could bring in federal dollars to speed up the program to replace lead pipes from the street to private houses. Baraka says he doesn't like the optics of National Guard troops in the city, but what if it means replacing pipes quicker?
At the end of the day, everybody knows that the infrastructure is bad, the same way we know that the tunnels going into New York City are terrible, and that one day, if they don't get fixed, it's going to be a terrible accident there. We just have to move our priorities into dealing with the infrastructure that needs to be dealt with.
The stop at the Community Food Bank of New Jersey here in Hillside shows Newark has a lot of generous donors. The food bank has collected hundreds of thousands of bottles of water after the call went out. Plainfield's mayor donated 5 truckloads.
It's overwhelming that, they want to help Newark out. And most of these people who gave all this water in, they're not, on the press. They're not on TV. They're not doing that. They got a call that their neighbors were in need.
Governor Phil Murphy on MSNBC's The 11th Hour with Brian Williams refuting critics who have said if Newark were an affluent suburb, this crisis would have been handled differently.
Affluent suburb, we already know that would be completely different if it was an affluent suburb. So there's no need for me to even play what he was going to say because we already know he's lying. Okay. Now, I want you to notice how the filtered water was testing positive for lead. The corrosion levels, they said the corrosion levels were not up to par. Okay, so that's going to be important as I go on with this video, okay? And don't trust them when they tell you that your house is okay and that house isn't okay and blah, 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 blah. I wouldn't trust that, okay? Just like they told the recipients of syphilis in Tuskegee, when they told them that this is treatment, I wouldn't believe them when they tell you that shit, okay? Let's see, Tariq Nasheed always says that when they are about to take you to slaughter, they put your own to do it. And to me, that's kind of what it looks like. I don't really know too much about y'all mayor in Newark, but that's kind of what it looks like to me. Because lead in your water where you drink, eat, and go to school is slaughter. Okay. I do understand the fact that he does not want to bring in the National Guards. That does create a bad look. But how the fuck can he compare the deterioration of the tunnel to water, which people are currently drinking and dying from every single day? See, the tunnel is going to be one day. We don't know what day that is. But in the meanwhile, people driving through just fine. That's not happening in New Jersey. In the meanwhile, people is dying and kids got lead in their bloodstream. But it's okay because we're going to have solutions in this video. All right. Aren't you tired of being recipients, of generous donors? I'm tired.
Dr. Mona Atisha, tell them.
There is no safe level of lead, none.
Atisha is a pediatrician who got involved in Flint's water problems when a mother asked her if the water was safe for her baby. She soon found out that it wasn't.
We had a home with a lead level of 22,000 parts per billion.
Newark's latest testing came back with lead levels of 52 parts per billion. The EPA says anything over 15 is dangerous to your health. In addition to high levels of lead, she says there's another similarity between Newark and Flint.
The water wasn't being treated properly. It was missing an important ingredient called corrosion control. Does that ring a bell? Something called orthophosphate.
In May, Newark started pumping orthophosphate through its water treatment plant in Pequannock. It coats the pipes to keep the lead from releasing, but it's a process that takes months. City officials say they've already replaced 175 lead service lines for homeowners and handed out 38,000 filters. Tonight, filters and lead test kits were being given.
See, here's why we have to educate ourselves. I say that they're doing this on purpose and that they know what they're doing and that they know that they're poisoning you and that they're not going to do anything to stop it, at least not in enough time to help you, my family. Okay, now learn a little bit more about this chemical.
Normally, water managers add orthophosphate to the water to prevent corrosion. The orthophosphate bonds with lead in the pipes, making a protective coating between the lead and the water. Where that shield is intact, corrosive chemicals like dissolved oxygen, O2, can't interact with the lead. This isn't a one-time solution. Orthophosphate has to be added continually, or the barrier breaks down. If it does break down, O2 reacts with lead atoms, oxidizing them. O2 takes electrons from the lead, grabs a couple of hydrogen protons, and turns into H2O, water. The result? Once oxidized, the lead dissolves into the water stream instead of sticking to the pipe. Flint Water Treatment Plant did not add orthophosphate, so the pipes broke down. That breakdown happened quickly for Flint. The river water had high levels of chloride, which accelerates corrosion. There were two possible sources of the chloride: ferric chloride used in conjunction with chlorine disinfection, and road salt applied during tough Michigan winters. The chemistry is hidden away in old buried pipes, but the result flows right into a drinking glass.
I say, they know. I say it was done on purpose. I say just like they can break down what the problem is in less than 60 seconds, they could have fixed the problem, and they knew it was a problem before it was a problem. So, and also, they knew when they were out there passing out those water filters that those water filters do not filter lead. I found that out in a Google search. So what filters out lead?
Little kids.
That's right.
So if there's any lead, if you know about anything, how does someone get the peace of mind and how do they protect themselves against it?
You're going to start by testing. You got to say, all right, I either go out and get a kit like this that I can do at a do-it-yourself level, or go to a third-party testing agency to just get the water tested.
Yeah.
The other thing is, don't be fooled that you think you can just get something like this that goes in the refrigerator and takes care of lead. This will take be for taste and odor. Some of these are for taste and odor, maybe for rust.
So this is something that you put maybe on the whole house?
That's right.
Right, and so that will not necessarily treat for lead.
The other thing to stress is that we're not worried about the water that you might shower in, do your laundry in, or flush down the toilet.
It's not going to leach into
it. It's only what you ingest. So you got to think about and look at the labels. You know, if you really want peace of mind, you really want to think about reverse osmosis, RO.
Right.
Okay, here's a unit here, pre-filter, post-filter, but in the middle, it's got this membrane. And with the membrane, you're driving water at the molecular level through this membrane. The only thing that can move through the membrane is H2O molecules. All the impurities remain back and flush away.
Which is
just gotta make sure it's on right, especially if you're doing it overnight. Wanna make sure it's on good. And then you turn the thing on. There it goes. And then this hose here was purchased separately, it's very long. So you may not be able to get that with the actual kit, because it kind of came with a shorter hose, but you may be able to ask for a longer hose, the intake hose, if you ask for it. We just didn't know to ask for it. But this is actually a piece of, what was it, ice machine hose you got?
It's for an ice machine.
eBay, some ice maker hose that we got, right?
Yeah.
A separate piece. So if you need extra of this, just know that you can get it like as ice maker hose and on eBay or other places that sell that type of thing.
It's like
Home Depot or whatever it might
It's like a standard size, a quarter inch polyethylene, something. something. We'll write it down in the description.
Yeah, when you go, if you go to the video under more info, down below the actual video screen, you'll see more info. You can click on that. And we'll write down the sources for this, the suppliers for these things, so we can share with you how we actually did this. Anyway, so what happened was, this here, and this here, the smaller cylinders, plus this larger one on the bottom, came with the original kit, as did a small cylinder in this place. Now, we had to change that around because we're in an older building with a lot of rusty pipes and things like that, and it just clogs the filter in an instant. So, so what we ended up doing was replacing the first canister that was actually in the original kit, because it came with three of these,
and then a set,
and then this thing here. Yeah, so it just wasn't powerful enough to handle these New York City pipes. So let me take you through the new system that we have here, that, and then we'll show you how it all underneath, and more info will show you where we got everything. So this hose here, the intake hose, goes into this big sort of a pre-filter.
Sediment filter.
Yeah. The goal of this is to basically take out iron and things, junk from the pipes that basically will clog up a filter in no time before it gets to your fancy filter, because this filter is much cheaper to replace than like this one. So it goes in through here first, and then you see the pipe goes around here up into a, what do we call this filter?
This is a pre-filter.
Another pre-filter, right?
The other one's a sediment, the first piece is a
sediment filter. Yeah, and this is
that's a pre-filter which starts removing chemicals.
Yeah, so some chemicals come out here, like some chlorine and things
like that.
And that's probably what your breeder filter might, you know, serve as that. Right. Now after this, it goes into this thing, and this is the reverse osmosis filter down here, the bigger one. And that is the one that takes the fluoride out. The only way to get fluoride out of your water is to reverse osmosis. There's no other way. You can't boil it, you can't.
There's another system.
What's the other system?
Dad has that, but it requires more chemical filters.
Okay, well that's a house filter.
You don't want that.
No, yeah. That's a house filter.
That's right.
Right, you have to filter it out. You have to have a special reverse osmosis filter. He has also reverse osmosis. I mean, his is that style. And so this filter here takes that out, and so by the time you get over here, the fluoride is gone. This is when your measurement is basically down to zero on the thing. And then the junk goes out through the yellow pipe.
Including the fluoride goes out through the yellow pipe.
Right, so this is your junk pipe here. This goes out into the outlet. And from this pipe over here, the water then goes over to the last filter, which is sort of a finishing filter, like a carbon filter type thing, that finishes and cleans out whatever is left over.
Makes it taste good.
Yeah. And then up here, and then we just attach this little fancy thing so this thing doesn't jump all over the place. This is just a home rig right here. You can use little bands from your vegetables, to, you know, little bands around this asparagus. That's what this is. And then you just hook that up in the way it's convenient for your bathtub, if you have to do it in the bathtub, and then into the jug. Now this is just a 5-gallon BPA-free jug, one of those 5-gallon drinking water jugs. And the only reason we have one of these is because it's very convenient for overnight filling for us. Because initially, we were trying to fill the small BPA-free containers. But guess what? If you had to do that overnight, you'd be up 3 times switching it, so which we weren't. But it was very inconvenient because it took longer to get water, because you need your faucets during the daytime if you live in a small apartment like we do. So you really can't afford to have a faucet occupied doing this stuff all day long. So, but if you're in a place with really good water pressure, you may be able to just jam through a bunch of these in the daytime, no problem.
I implore you, especially my family members in New Jersey, to learn more about this. Look in the description. I have the links to all the videos, to all my sources in the description and in the comments. This is a way for us to do for ourselves. Family, they said that system costs $250 and they set it up in their bathtub, okay? So I propose that we start doing this ourselves. Do for ourselves, okay? And share water with each other. You can filter it yourself, share it with yourselves, and you don't have to beg or ask anybody for anything. For $250, you can water the block.
Take Now, to make your own alkaline water, you will need 2 liters purified water, 1 teaspoon Himalayan salt, 1 organic lemon, sliced. Preparing the concoction. Fill a big or filtered and clean jar with water, throw the lemon slices in it and make sure you don't spill a single drop of the liquid. Then mix a teaspoon of Himalayan pink salt, seal the jar and let it stay overnight at room temperature. Drink 3 glasses of the alkaline water the next morning, but do this always before you eat or drink anything. This concoction restores the pH balance in your body, so hurry up and make it, your body will be grateful. The Alka Pitcher makes instant alkaline water. This new product is a cost-effective way to filter and alkalize your water, so you may want to try it. Thank you and may this...
So I took a college course called Natural Conservation. And in this class, we learned, you know, just about water and how important it is to protect it and how much it means to us in life. And I remember this was the same time that, at the time, his name was Mos Def. Mos Def had put out the album that had that song, New World Water, on it. I can't remember which album it was. Look, I can't remember everything. And I remember I used that song for my paper, my presentation in class. And I got an A. I used that as he was the intro to whatever I wrote. And I believe that year, I had written 2 papers in class like that. I don't remember what the second class was, but I had written 2 papers in class that completely rhymed from beginning to end. It completely rhymed. It met all the requirements of the class, but the whole thing rhymed from beginning to end. And my teachers, my professors were elated to receive something that I put that much effort into. And so I just wanted to share that personal story with you about this song and what it means to me and my premonitions, I guess, even as a young girl, about how important water would be in our future.
There's nothing more refreshing than having a clear, crisp, clean glass of water on a warm summer's day.
That cool, refreshing drink.
Try it with your friends.
New World Water makes the tide rise high. Come inland and make your house go by. Fools done upset the old man river. Made him carry slave ships and fed him dead niggas. Now his belly full and he about to flood something. So I'm throwing rope that ain't tied to nothing. Tell your crew use the H2 and Y's amounts. It's the new world water and every drop counts. You can laugh and take it as a joke if you wanna, but it don't rain a full week some summers. And it's about to get real wild in the half. You be buying every yard just to take a fucking bath. Heads is acting wild, sipping brew and puffing dank. Competing with the next man for higher playing rank. So now I ain't got time trying to be Big Hank. Fuck a bank. I need a 20-year water tank. Cause while these knuckleheads is out here sweating their guts, the sun is sitting in the treetops, burning the woods. And as the flame from the blaze get higher and higher, they say, don't drink the water, we need it for the fire. New York is drinking it. New World. And all of California is drinking it. New World. Way up north and down south is drinking it. New World. Used to have minerals and zinc in it. New World. Now they say it got lead and stink in it. New World. Fluorocarbons and monoxide. Push the water table lopside. Used to be free, now of course you a fee. Cause all tanks fully loaded, they roll across the sea. Man, you gotta cook with it, baby, clean with it.
That's right.
When it's hot summertime, you fiend for it.
No.
You gotta put it in the iron, you steaming with.
That's right.
It's what they dress wounds and treat diseases
Shout
with.
It out.
The rich and poor, black and white got need for
That's
it.
Right.
And everybody in the world can agree with
Let
this.
Know.
Consumption promotes health and easiness.
That's
Go
right.
too long without. doubt it on this earth and you leaving
it. It out.
Americans wasting it on some leisure shit.
Say word.
Another nation be desperately seeking it. Bacteria washing up on they beaches.
Say word.
Don't drink the water so they can't wash their feet with
it.
Young babies in perpetual neediness.
Say word.
Epidemics hopping up off the petri dish. Control center shot a play all secret.
Say word.
To avoid public panic and freakiness.
Say
there are places where TB is common as TV. Cause foreign based companies go and get greedy. The type of cats who pollute the whole shoreline. Have it purified and sell it for $1.25. Now the world is drinking it.
New
your mom's wife and baby girl is drinking it.
New world.
Up north and down south is drinking it.
New world.
You just have to go to your sink for it.
New
the
world
cash
water.
Registers is going to chink for it.
New world.
Carbon monoxide. Got the fish looking cockeyed. Used to be free. Now of course you a feed. Cause it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money. Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money. Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting your cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting that 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 cash.
Money.
Johnny cash.
Money.
Roseanne cash.
Money.
Give me cash.
Money.
Cold cash.
Money.
Johnny cash.
Money.
Roseanne cash.
Money.
Give me cash.
Money.
Cash rule everything around me. Move.